Look at that sucker right there, boy. Old Mike done pulled a chunk up out of the yard. Good day in the morning.
Let's stick him right back in there and give him a little tap. Now, when I'm plugging, if I make a mistake in the yard like this, I'll take a mental note of where that spot is, and that's roughed up really good, and I'll try to stay off of that so I don't damage it even more. You have to remember, this is commercial equipment. You can do severe damage to a client's yard or to your own yard if you're not careful.
Hey there, it's Pete with GCI Turf. Hope you're having a great day today, and I'm here at my home with my buddies Michael and Giovanni from up in Virginia. They came down to help me aerate and overseed my yard, and they've never been on a commercial piece of equipment, lawn care equipment, so it's my job to teach them. So number one, they can be safe. They don't get hurt on it, because it's the last thing I want to do is send them back home to their bride and with a broke leg or broke arm, or somebody gets run over with a plugger, and we don't want that to happen, right? All right, Giovanni.
Sir.
First impression, just your basic first impression when you look at this, what's the first thought that comes to your mind?
Scared.
Scared.
Yes, sir.
Good word. Mike?
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Okay, so this is probably because we have two different guys. I know Mike personally. He's been on some of this type of stuff before, so he's used to it. He's comfortable with it. He run my right ZK last night, so he's probably not as timid with using it. Giovanni, you've never been on something like this, right?
Not at all, sir.
That's why he's scared, okay? He don't mess my daggone monetization up. You reckon it will?
No. No, we'll just...
That music.
We'll just clip out.
Yeah, then we got to do that all over.
No. Yeah, because you want all that to be...
It'll be fine.
It's fine.
That's right, so Giovanni's scared.
Honestly, a lot of times you think, you hear that, you don't hear it sometimes in the video.
Because okay. The road,
like I see a lot of y'all YouTubers saying,
so it's coming this way.
Okay,
yeah.
Good. Okay. All right, what did I say?
Scared, never been on here before.
Scared, never been on here before. I'm ready to go.
And he's ready to go. Okay.
I'm just kidding. I just wanted to have two different.
Yeah, that's good.
That's right. So he just said he's kidding, he's really scared. So basically, you stand on this platform and you do all your operation from this one platform. So I don't know the technical word for this bar, a brace bar, grab handle, what they call them in a Jeep, a Osh.
A Nerf ball.
One of those handles. So this is your, I try not to operate the machine like this because it's powerful, it's strong. It will jerk you around, and if you start jerking and doing this, it's going to throw you clean off of it. So your number one priority is to always have a good grip right here. And then from there, you're going to use your thumbs and your palm to operate the machine like that. When you're backing up, they've got another bar here that I can brace against like that. That way I don't have to try and do it like this, because if you jerk it too hard, the machine's gonna go, and you're gonna go too.
It's ready.
Yeah, this is a full-blown commercial electronic fuel injected. I don't know what the horsepower is on it, 30, FT73. I don't know what the horsepower is, but it's freaking strong.
It's big.
So the way the machine operates is the motor is, of course, the engine of it. It makes everything go. You have hydraulic pumps here. Those hydraulic pumps, when you compress this and mash it forward, it sends hydraulics to the wheel motors. That in turn turns the wheel motor. Parking brake right here. Key, throttle. And when we're doing our little test run, if you guys will, we're going to run it about half throttle, just to let you get used to it, let you get kind of comfortable on it, I guess.
How about turtle?
Turtle, we can turtle speed it. And then once we do that, then we'll be ready to plug. Now, you see this button right here? That little button, when you stand on it, the tines go in the ground.
Oh.
Okay? When you take your foot off of it, the tines come up.
Wow.
So why is that important?
So when you're coming up, or like
corner. Near a driveway, concrete, you don't want to be having your tines.
Exactly. Down. These tines belong in the ground. They don't belong anywhere else on this property, okay? Another good reason for that is when you turn around and make a zero turn,
up the ground.
You must pick the tines up. They have to come up. If you don't, I know the yard looks pretty rough right now, but it's really going to look rough if you do that.
Do we need to sign something, Pete? Or?
No disclaimers. No disclaimers. The cool thing about all this is if you screw something up, I know a pretty good dude that can fix it.
Yeah.
So.
I know that guy.
All right. Now, this is something unique to this machine. You see this time control button right here? Now, when I have it in the middle, I can press this all I want and it won't do anything. Okay? Gotcha. When I click it left and depress the button, the tines go down. I have to keep my foot on the button for the tines to stay down. The minute I move my foot, the tines come up. When I depress the button to the right, it reverses that effect. Mm. So now, which I love, I absolutely love it. Big yards, I don't have to focus and keep my foot there.
Right.
When I want to turn around, I depress the button. It lifts the tines up.
I think I like that better.
When I get straight, I move my foot, and that way I don't have to focus on keeping my foot there. Because I can't tell you with other machines where they don't have that feature, I've been riding along, my foot's not on the button. I've been plugging for 3 or 4 minutes and not doing a dang thing. You know what I mean? So I always run it with that down so the tines are automatically in the ground, but when I want to make a turn, I hit the button and they pick it up. Now I have to hold the button. It's not a click up, click down. You have to keep your foot on it. The word zero turn, that's what they're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
I can make a letter zero or a number zero because it zeros right on itself. I mean, I didn't move but turn the machine all the way around. The trick to that is these have to be equally yoked, okay? Meaning if I'm going forward with this tire at a speed, this one has to be right about the same speed so that they're reversing. If I leave this one still and just do this one, that tire doesn't move and it'll leave a nasty turnaround mark in the yard.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Kind of like what I did with the right
somebody
mower.
Somebody left one in my yard with my right mower last night. I was like, who in the world done that? And I remembered.
This guy.
No, this guy was on it. So, but it's all good. We can fix that today. So that's the main thing is you want to,
And then when you do that, you hold like.
Exactly. That's the way I personally do it.
Yeah.
Is I'll grab that and just rest my thumb there just to have a brace.
Mm-hmm.
Just kind of easily pull it back. And same way with that. Now, when I'm turning without a zero turn, I'm going to have both forward and then let off one and push one just a little bit more. But in my mind, I'm always thinking, don't let that inside tire stop. Because if I do, it's going to whip around and
you're going to get lost. Yeah.
You're going to get a gash.
Yeah, well, you're going to rip the turf up right under that wheel.
Yep, you're going to tear the turf up right there.
Mm-hmm. So. That makes sense. You see the one over there with that ZK? That's what happened too.
It'll rip it all to pieces.
I didn't even think about it. I'm like,
all right, so we're just going to take the machine out here in the street and let them ride it down the street a little bit, turn it around, get used to that. I'm going to watch the tires, and once we do that, we'll get in the yard. Where's your foot at? Look at your right foot. There you go. Kick it off that button. So when you see those guys mowing and they're zipping down and whoop and zipping back and zipping and zipping, and when you don't see any damage in the yard, you know those guys are really good at what they're doing. Mm-hmm. They've been on these machines for a while, they're comfortable. And because that's one of my major pet peeves with our customers, is don't tear the grass up. It's already hard enough. Yeah. Don't add insult to injury by tearing their grass up.
Especially like after a big rain or something.
Oh yeah, it's really important mowing, when it's wet.
And you're mowing.
That's when we're going to the 3-point turn, but that's something different. Boy, that is nasty right there, man. Don't do that. Do not do that.
My gosh, don't do that.
No, my gosh, don't do that. That's crazy. So, one of the unique features about this machine is you can make a slight turn, or actually a pretty good turn, with the tines in the ground. You just can't zero turn it. So we're gonna work on doing that all day, because the more these tines are in the ground, the more efficient we are. Every time we have to pick them up and turn around, we lose time. Time's money in the business, blah, blah, blah. That's one of my favorite things about this, is we don't have to slow down. We can just keep making circles and plugging all at the same time. And of course, you got to stop every now and then and pick it up, turn around. But I'm gonna kind of demonstrate about the severity of the turn that you can make and be completely safe. You just kind of watch it and you'll get a feel for it. There you go. That's about the severity of a turn. And of course, you can actually turn it a little bit more, but since I've got some guys in the yard that, you know, aren't completely comfortable with it yet, they will be when they leave, we're going to kind of limit the turning radius. I guess that's a good way to say it. All right, so that right there is about 1.5 inches, roughly, maybe close to 2 inches. And on this machine, I can run at about 250 psi with the softness of my ground. Now, if my ground's harder, obviously I'm going to bump the psi to get the same depth of plug. And if the ground's really wet, I may not even need quite that much. Heck, we've aerated yards just on 200 and pull a really good plug. All right, so let's say you get in a situation, you're a little spooked or whatever, and you're getting it and you're going, and you just want everything to stop because you want to be safe. What do you do?
You'll probably hit the PTO stop button or emergency stop button.
It ain't got one.
Let go, well, not let go. Probably unsafe. You don't want to just fully let go of that, right?
Just get off of it.
Maybe jump off.
Just jump off.
If I'm running and I'm in danger, let's say I'm going down a hill or a slope and the machine's getting away from me, I'm just going to step off. Who cares about the machine?
Well,
you know what I'm saying? It ain't worth me getting hurt and getting beat up over this thing. Of course, that's not going to happen here. We're on flat ground.
Right, right.
But if you were operating in on a ditch, a slope, just step off of it and let the machine go.
Right.
So we want to kind of plug over the whole yard one time, and then we're going to go back and plug over it another way in a different direction. Then we're going to go over it and plug it again in another different direction. The only thing I ask is my flags, just stay clear of them. Don't worry about getting super close. I'll go back and touch that up. My edges, don't worry about getting right up against them. I'll go back and touch that up. And other than that, we're just try not to go over the same spot a million times, because you'll turn it into a plowed field with this machine. So just kind of keep a mental note. I've been here, done that. So I'm gonna move over just a little bit. And you can actually, when you're standing on the machine, you'll see your plug line beside you, and your tire is gonna kind of overlap that just a little bit, because see, our head unit is inside
the tire, yep.
Right? It's inside, so you're actually gonna ride on some of the plugs you've already did. Not a big deal, who cares? But that way you get good overlap with your plugging.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. All right, go ahead and start making a little bit of a turn and working back around.
just a little bit. Pull up just a little bit. Go ahead, pull up a little bit. All right, cut it off just for a second. Let me show you something. What'd you do wrong?
Jacked up.
You didn't pull up. You didn't pick your tines up, and that's completely fine. Don't worry about it. That can be fixed. That ground's moist. So all I'm gonna do is stick that root system back down in there and pat it down a little bit, like that. That's no big deal.
Tines up is hit.
Tines up.
Touch, okay.
When you're running the machine, the tines are in the ground.
Yes.
When you want to make a turn or turn around, step on the button.
Okay.
When you get lined up and going straight again, take your foot off the button.
Okay.
Cool. Okay. He's doing good. If I had a lot of time to work with him, we're kind of limited today. But if I had all day to work with him and really get focused on him and show him some little tips and tricks, that man right there could run that thing wide open. Ain't no doubt in my mind. Tines are up, making his turn. We get a little bit of a tear right there off the wheel. Tines are down. There he goes. Let's go check out Mike. Woo! Hey! Look at that sucker right there, boy. Old Mike done pulled a chunk up out of the yard. Good day in the morning. Show y'all is what full speed looks like on a commercial machine. Okay, so we've showed what to, and again, not at all picking on y'all, it's just you're realistically your first time on this. I can't expect you to
I jacked it up over there.
It took me years to be able to get to the speed I'm at, so I'm gonna show you what these machines are capable, and then you'll understand that time's money. And man, when we roll up to a yard and plug it, we are in and out. The quality doesn't suffer. It's because we got good equipment. Fast, ain't it?
I think so. Yeah, that's,
and that's the speed me and my crews go at all day long, every day. And of course, this is a nice flat yard. You can open it up and let it roll. When you get smaller yards, of course, you have to dial it back. It's common, you have to use common sense on the machine. So that's kind of the process I take, is when I train a new employee or something, I kind of, regardless of what they tell me, is I'm gonna take the time, kind of go over the machine, say this does that, this does that, and then let them go, and the more you do it, the better you get at it. So appreciate Mike and Gio letting me show you that.
We appreciate you teaching us.
Oh yeah, it's absolutely my pleasure. And you guys have a great day, and we'll check you later.
Don't forget to tell all your buddies.
Oh yeah, that's right. It helps y'all be here. Remind, like, subscribe, and share, and tell all your buddies. Check you later.